So in the past two lectures, we have learned the alternative test for two independent samples and two pair samples for non-parametric test. So the next non-parametric test we're going to learn is the correlation test. The Spearman correlation test is an alternative to the Pearson correlation test. This is the test that we would use when our data violate the assumption of the Pearson correlation test in terms of the normality and also the linearity. So as a Pearson correlation, there are two elements for Spearman correlation test. First, we need to calculate the correlation coefficients. Second, we need to perform t-test for the calculated correlation coefficients. For Spearman correlations, the correlation coefficient is calculated differently from the Pearson correlation. So the formula is different. After that, we would like to perform the statistical test. We are going to use the same t-test, just as what we did for the Pearson correlations. So instead of using the Pearson correlation coefficient, we're going to use the Spearman correlation coefficients in the t-test formula. It's good that you do the revisions for the correlations in week number 8 about the Pearson correlations when we perform the t-test. So for the Pearson correlation, if you remember, this is our formula. In the formula, we will use the parameter or statistic of the sample, which is the mean and also the standard deviations. Spearman correlation is a non-parametric test, so we are not going to use this formula to get the correlation coefficient for Spearman correlations. However, for the statistical test, we're going to use the same t-test. The only difference is for the correlation coefficient, we're going to replace this Pearson correlation coefficient with the Spearman correlation coefficient, which is calculated differently. After we have obtained the correlation coefficient for Spearman, then we will use this in the formula. So to calculate the correlation coefficient for Spearman correlations, this is the formula. So what you see here is very simple. You have a value 6, value 1, 1 minus 6, multiplied by the sum of rank. So this one we're going to show you how to calculate this. Divide by the number of observation. So the D stands for the difference between an S and Y rank. So for correlation, we have two variables, the S and Y variable, that measure from the same Spearman unit. So for this Spearman correlation, we're going to first find the difference between the two variables, then after that, rank the difference. So as usual, we will start with research questions. So the question is there a relationship between the body height and the size of shoe for the student in this class? In order to answer these questions, I have to design the experiment, which is my second step. We're going to collect the data of the body height as my first variable and also the shoe size from 10 students. That means that for each student, I'm going to measure their body height and also measure the shoe size. The third step is to organize the data in a table. So this is how I should organize the data for research questions to investigate the relationship. Then I can make a chart. So this is the scatter plot. Okay, to plot the S and Y value for each of the observations. If there are 10 students, that means there will be a 10 dot. Okay, and then for each student, I have the measurement of the body height and also the shoe size. So just by looking at the graph, it seems there's a positive relationship. So the next step is to perform the statistical analysis. Okay, so the first step is to formulate the research questions. Second is to design your experiment. We have to explain our experiment design in detail in terms of the variable, the observation unit, the sample, and also grouping, if there's a grouping. The third step is to organize the data. The fourth step is to summarize your data. So the last step in our research will be data analysis. We will choose which statistical analysis to be used. But before we choose the data analysis, we need to test for the normality and homogeneity of variance for our data set. So let's say in this case, after I test for normality, I found that the data is not normally distributed. Then I cannot use the Pearson correlation coefficients, the parametric test. So I have to use the alternative test, which is a non-parametric test. The first thing is I need to calculate the correlation coefficient before I perform the t-test. The first thing that we need to do is to rank the s variable. So this is the first variable. So we rank according to the value. The smallest value, we put the number one rank. Then the second smallest, we put number two, and so on and so forth. So we're going to rank all the value for the first variable. Then after that, we rank the value for the second variable. The next step is very important, which we're going to calculate the difference between the rank. So in this case, for the first observation, the rank for the body height and shoe size is 2 and 2. So we have to find the difference between the rank. So in this case, it's 2 minus 2 is equal to 0. For the second observation, is 3 minus 6 is equal to negative 3. After we have find the difference between the rank of S and Y variables, the next step is to square the difference of rank. After we square the difference, remove all the sign, the negative sign in our value. Then we can sum all the value. So this is a very important value we're going to use for the calculation of Spearman correlation coefficients. So to calculate the correlation coefficient, this is a formula. We put the sum of square difference of rank, which is 30, into the formula. Then we have the constant of value 6 divided by the n is 10, so we have 10 students. So it's 10 power of 3 minus 10. After you solve the equation, then we will get the value. So this is our correlation coefficient for Spearman correlations. After we get the value, the next step is to perform the statistical test by following the same procedure as we're going to use the t-test. So first is to formulate a statistical hypothesis. After that, set the criteria, calculate the t-score, and then compare our calculated t-score with the criteria, which is the critical statistical value, and then make a decision whether we reject or not to reject the null hypothesis. So for the hypothesis, it's similar to the Pearson correlations. So for the null hypothesis is there is no relationship between body height and size of shoe for the student. And the alternative hypothesis, there is a relationship between the two variables. So this is similar to the Pearson correlations. After that, we need to set the criteria. So in this case, the criteria we're going to set is for the t-test. So we need to refer to the t-table. So before that, we have to decide what is our significant level or alpha. So in this case, we set our significant level as 0.05. Then we need to calculate the degree of freedom. And then decide whether this is a one-tail or two-tail test. So for correlation coefficient, we always use the two-tail test. So in this case, our degree of freedom is equal to the number of observations minus 2. So we have 10 observations, so it's 10 minus 2 equal to 8. so we can get our critical T from the table. So in this case, our critical T for alpha 0.05 to tail degree of freedom A is 2 side 0.05. So in this case, our T value is 2.306. Then the next step is to get the T score. So just now, you have already calculated the correlation coefficient by using the formula. So after that, we need to get the standard error for the correlation coefficients. So the correlation coefficient that we have calculated just now is 0.818. So what we need to do, we need to put this value in the formula of standard error of correlation coefficients. After that, just solve the formula to get the standard errors for correlation coefficient for Spearman. So after we get the value, then we can continue to our t-test. So what we need to do, we need to put the correlation coefficient, the Spearman correlation coefficient, put the standard error that we have just calculated just now, and then get our calculated t. So after we get our calculated t or our t score, then we can move to the next step, which is compare our calculated t with the critical value. So the critical value that we obtain from the t table is 2.306, and our calculated t is 4.03. So if you are not confident, you can draw a graph. So this is the distribution t for the degree of freedom A, then our critical value is 2.306 and it is a two-tailed test. In this case, our critical value is 4 inside the rejection region. In this case, we are going to make a conclusion to reject the null hypothesis, because our test score is larger than the critical value. And to make a conclusion, we will reject the null hypothesis and accept that the alternative hypothesis, which means there is a relationship between the body height and size of shoe for students in this class.